Jet 24, here's meteorologist Tom Atkins, your weather authority.
Well, we're looking for stars tonight, but I don't know if the Kanye Lake Christmas trees have them, but there's a very pretty shot on our channel lock cam and nice reflection into the lake there. So lots to talk about. Of course, no moon, no star Bethlehem, and no planetary conjunction junction tonight. Not visible because of our ever-abundant cloud cover. And you can see it right here. I mean, you can't even drive out of this stuff. And as we expand the zone, so to speak, even when, you know, Chicago got a little break and then more clouds came down from Milwaukee, all across Ohio, Pennsylvania, Bulmer, Washington, up into New York. So tough for the Northeast. But maybe you got a friend, and you can always go to the interweb, and there'll be pictures. What we have, in addition to the clouds, some showers and drizzle and mist moving in again, and you can see a little pink down there, so there's going to be some wet snow with this. But as advertised, Mother Nature's timing, look at this. Christmas Eve starts rainy and mild, afternoon and evening goes to snow just in time for jolly old Saint Nick, and then lake effect, wind, snow, and cold on Christmas Day. Our high today, 40, our low at 36. Nothing really impressive here. No measured precipitation. Our snowfall remains well below normal for the month of December and well below normal for the snowfall season. It is the first day of winter, therefore the shortest daylight of the year, 9 hours and 6 minutes. Wet snow or some mixed precip into tomorrow. Dry, milder, good getting out and about weather on Wednesday. And then after that, we'll get to that in a minute. Crew at the Bayfront at 40. Lake Erie temperature at 39. Larry in Lake City, 38. Brian in North Harbor Creek, 39. Liz and Corey at 35. 34, Janet in Cambridge. 35, Dave in Cranesville. 36, Joyce in North Meadville. Titusville at 35, Warren at 35, Saybrook at 33, and so is Chandler's Valley. So it's a cold, dank night. We've got this little weak system here, but what I want you to see is the fact that we got a little bit of surge of milder temperatures for Wednesday, and then the big dip in the jet stream. So when you talk about lake effect, you got to determine the wind direction to determine who gets the most. Southwest winds shuffle the heaviest snow to Buffalo. Westerly flow, northern Erie County into ski country in New York. And, of course, the ominous northwest with a double fetch off Lake Huron and Erie give the heaviest snows to the snow belt. So you can see right here, this is just a weak system, and that's going to be kicking out for tomorrow. So tomorrow night and into Wednesday, we get the southerly red streamers, maybe a little sun, mild temperatures. Now, as this thing comes through, rain goes to snow on Christmas Eve, and behind it, we look for those wind directions with the heavier squalls. And for now, it's kind of a west to southwest flow, probably going to the northwest, so snow belts will probably get hit with the heaviest of this situation. But everybody's looking like a white Christmas. Rain or wet snow tonight, maybe up to an inch along the lake shores. Temperatures stay mainly above freezing. Edinburgh, Meadville, Titusville could see 1 to 3 inches in the belts, 28 to 32. Jamestown, Warren, Tynesta in the mountains. Any mix goes to snow, 1 to 3 inches for you folks, 27 to 31. So there's your break day Wednesday, well into the 40s. As advertised, rain to snow on Christmas Eve, lake effect with accumulations, probably heaviest in the snow belts. Winding down on Saturday, chance of flurries Sunday, and maybe some late precip on Monday, but the end of that forecast period doesn't look too bad. Check out that 7-day and the radars 24 hours a day on the weather page at YourErie.com. That's it for me, Sean.